Let's see, what will I learn today? Plastic. I'm partially plastic. Plastic is the greatest invention in the history of the world. Hello, structure friend. Can you read over my report?
Of course. I'm confused. What about all the garbage and animals that are hurt by plastic?
Plastic would never hurt anyone.
I'm not sure. What if we had no plastic?
Yeah, great idea. Simulation activated. Plastic doesn't come from nature like wood or cotton. Plastic was invented by people in a science lab. There are lots of types of plastic with many useful properties. How do paper cups work if paper can't hold water? If you look carefully, the paper cup is lined with plastic because plastic is waterproof. A bicycle helmet protects your head and neck if you have an accident. A bike helmet uses many types of plastic. An outer shell made of strong plastic, a foam liner made of lightweight plastic, and a strap made of flexible plastic. Eyeglasses were originally made from glass. Imagine if you tripped and fell. Ouch! Today, eyeglasses are made from plastic that won't break or crack. Hearing aids use electricity to increase the amount of sound a person can hear. Plastic stops the electricity from shocking the person wearing the hearing aid. Plus, plastic is easy to clean, and it can be made to fit into any shape ear.
Yay! Wow, I didn't realize how important plastic was.
You were right too. Plastic does have some big environmental problems. Plastic is so cheap and easy to make that many plastic objects are only used once. Each year, 500 billion plastic bags are made. And the average lifespan of these bags is only 15 minutes before they become garbage. Ooh, there's something smelly in that bin.
What happens when we throw them away?
Well, plastic doesn't rot like a banana peel. Instead, it breaks down into smaller pieces, and eventually tiny pieces called microplastics. A plastic bag takes 20 years to break down. A plastic toothbrush takes 500 years to break down.
But we can recycle it, right?
Unfortunately, 91% of plastic isn't recycled, or can't be recycled. Plastic ends up in our landfills, our oceans, and even on our streets. Sometimes animals like turtles or birds will eat plastic by mistake. Other animals become tangled in plastic and can't escape.
So, is it good or bad?
It's neither. Plastic is a material that makes our lives safer, easier, and more comfortable. But if we use too much plastic and aren't careful how we get rid of it, we have problems.
What should we do?
Well, we all know the three R's. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Start with reducing how much plastic you use. Instead of using lots of plastic water bottles, use a refillable metal water bottle. Reuse what you can. If clothes don't fit anymore, give them to someone who can wear them. Lastly, properly recycle what's left over.
Thanks, Cosmo. I learned a lot.
Me too. Bye!
Bye!
Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. Plastic is an incredibly useful material that has made our lives safer and easier. Unfortunately, we throw too much plastic in the garbage. What if you investigated how your home uses and throws away plastic? Step 1, find an adult Step 2. For 1 week, carefully sort all your garbage into 2 categories. Plastic and everything else. Wash the plastic garbage as best you can and store it in a clean, dry place. Step 3. At the end of the week, examine your plastic garbage. What can you reuse? What plastic garbage can you avoid making in the future? What can be recycled? Step 4. Create a family plan. What can your family do to create less plastic garbage? What will be the challenges? How can you make your plan successful? Happy planning, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!